I'm Nisha from nisahomey.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make oil-free, quick and easy Indian curry gravy in pressure cooker. This curry looks so tempting that nobody will guess there is no oil in it. It is so healthy and so easy to make. I had a request for an oil-free recipe from Saima Fawad. Hi Saima, I hope I pronounced your name correctly. Please do try this recipe and I hope you will enjoy this as much as my family did. If you guys have a recipe request, please feel free to comment below. To make oil-free curry gravy, I'm using 2 medium-sized onions, 4 medium-sized tomatoes, 6 cloves of garlic, 1 inch ginger, about 1 tablespoon of chopped coriander leaves, 1 sprig of mint leaves, about 10 cashew nuts. Cashew nut is optional, but it does give a slight thickness to the gravy, so I like to add cashew nuts. Now into my pressure cooker, I'm adding in the cashew nuts, chopped coriander leaves, a sprig of mint leaves, garlic cloves. I'm roughly chopping the ginger and adding this into the cooker. I'm cutting the onion into 4, the next one also, and tomatoes. I'm removing the stem part and I'm making a cross on top, so after this is cooked it will be easier to remove the skin if you're removing. Try to use bright red color tomatoes so that it will give a nice color to the curry. I'm adding in 1.5 teaspoons salt or as needed. I'm adding in 1/3 to 1/2 cup water. I'm using 1/2 cup water. Now switch on the flame and cover the cooker with its lid. Allow the cooker to give out 5 whistles and after 5 whistles, switch off the flame and allow the cooker to depressurize by itself. So that's the first whistle. Now 4 more whistles to go. Let's remove the weight. Always remove the weight first before opening the cooker. Now open the cooker. Everything is nicely cooked and the tomato skin has come out. Now you can just remove the skin like this, but I normally don't remove the skin. If you don't like the skin, you can just peel it off like this. Now you can allow this to cool down completely and puree this in a blender. But since I don't have time to waste and I'm doing this very quickly for dinner, I'm using my immersion blender to blend this up. So now the tomatoes and onions are nicely blended. Now I'm going to switch on the flame again. Just give this a mix. And now simmer the flame. And I'm adding in 1 to 1.5 teaspoon Kashmiri chili powder. You can increase or decrease according to your tolerance. If you're making this for kids, use only 1 teaspoon Kashmiri chili powder. I'm using 1.5 teaspoon Kashmiri chili powder. 1/2 teaspoon turmeric, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon cumin or jeera powder. Now give this a mix. I'm adding in 1/2 cup frozen peas. You can add any vegetable of your choice like carrots, potato, cauliflower, broccoli, any vegetable of your choice. That's 1/2 cup of frozen peas and 50 grams of paneer. The link to make homemade paneer will be given in the description box below. Now slowly mix this. The gravy is already thick and you don't need to add any extra water. You just have to simmer it for about 2 to 3 minutes. So for that, I'm just closing the cooker with its lid just for another 2 to 3 minutes so that the peas and the paneer gets cooked thoroughly. It's about 3 minutes now. Let's check on the curry. The gravy is thick. If you want, you can add 1/4 cup of water. To me, this looks the right consistency. Thick tomato gravy. And I'm adding in a sprig of fresh curry leaves. Some coriander leaves chopped, about 1 tablespoon. 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi. Just rub this with your hand and add. This gives a nice flavor to the curry. Now mix everything well. You can check salt at this stage. If you feel you need more salt, you can add a pinch or two. I'm adding in 1/2 teaspoon sugar. This is just to balance all the flavors. Again, mix this well. Lastly, I'm adding in 1 to 2 tablespoon curd or dahi. You can also use fresh cream, but since I'm trying to make this as healthy as possible, I'm using homemade curd or yogurt. My easy and quick oil-free Indian curry gravy is ready to serve. Switch off the flame. Remember that the curry will thicken slightly when it cools down, so you can add about 1/4 cup of water if you need. Please note that I simmered the gravy on low flame. If you put on medium or high flame, since the gravy is thick, it might get burnt or stick to the bottom. Now let me serve this curry. If you want a dairy-free curry, you can omit the paneer and add boiled potatoes and omit the yogurt or curd which I added towards the end. As you can see that the gravy is very thick and it is perfect with roti, naan or chapati. Just before serving, I'm drizzling little curd or yogurt. And sprinkle some chopped coriander leaves.